Good morning, students. Today we will going to study from your Hornbill book, Lesson 1, The Portrait of Our Lady by Khushwant Singh. About the author. Author name Khushwant Singh. He was born on 2nd February 1915, Hadali, Pakistan. He passed away on 20th March 2014 at Sujan Singh Park, Delhi. The name of his wife was Kawal Malik. His education part, he has completed his education from different universities, colleges. He has completed his education from GCU, Punjab University, King's College, London, the Dixon Poon School of Law, St. Stephen College. He had received number of awards also. He had received Padma Bhushan Award, Padma Vibhushan Award, Punjab Ratan Award. Now we will going to discuss about the theme. The Portrait of a Lady is a part of an autobiography by Khushwant Singh. In this story, the author draws a pen portrait of his grandmother. He beautifully unfolds their relationship and how it undergoes several changes. In other words, the story is a loving tribute from a grandson to his grandmother. The story gives a picture of human relationship. It is a realistic account of how the grandparents give all their time, attention, and love to their grandchildren. Now we will going to discuss about the characters. First, we will going to discuss about the grandmother. Khushwant Singh's grandmother is described as extremely religious person. She was a very kind lady. She was short, fat, and slightly bent. Her face was wrinkled, and she was always dressed in spotless white clothes. In village, she took care of all the needs of the author when he was a child. Now, we will going to discuss about Khushwant Singh. He recounts his childhood days and his relationship with his grandmother. Now we will going to discuss a summary. The author remembers his grandmother and grandfather. The author recalls his grandmother as a very old lady. For the 20 years that the author had known his grandmother, he had found her old and wrinkled. It was hard for him to believe that she had once been young and pretty and she had a husband. Khushwant Singh's grandfather's portrait hung on the wall of the drawing room. He wore a big turban. His clothes were loose. He looked at least 100 years old. Looking at his portrait, one could not imagine him in his youth with his wife and children. Now we will going to discuss about the author's grandmother. The thought of the grandmother being young and pretty was almost revolting to him. She was short, fat, and slightly bent in stature. Her face was a crisscross of wrinkles. Her silvery white hair was scattered over her wrinkled face. The author remembered her hobbling around the house in spotless white clothes, with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop and the other hand busy counting the beads of her rosary. Her lips constantly move in inaudible prayer. To the author, she could never have been pretty, but she reflected a divine beauty. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains. Now we will going to see the author's childhood with his grandmother. The author and his grandmother were good friends. His parents left him to stay with her when they shifted to the city. In the village, his grandmother took care of all his needs. She was quite active and agile. She used to wake him up in the morning and get him ready for school. She said her morning prayers in a sing-song manner while she bathed and dressed him in the hope that her grandson would learn them by heart. The author listened to the prayers because he loved her voice but never bothered to learn them. Then she would fetch his wooden slate, which she had already washed and plastered it with yellow chalk. She would take an earthen ink pot and a reed pan and tie them in a bundle and hand it to the author. After having a thick stale chapatis with a little butter and a sugar spread on it for breakfast, they used to leave for school. The author's grandmother always accompanied him to the school as it was attached to the temple. The author at the school. The priest taught children the alphabet and the morning prayer. The children sat in two rows in the veranda. They would sing the alphabet or the prayer in a chorus while the author learned his lessons at school. The grandmother would read scriptures in the adjoining temple. On their way back, they would feed stale chapatis to the dogs. The turning point in the relationship of grandmother and the author. The turning point came in their relationship when they moved to the city to stay with Khushwant Singh's parents. In the city, the author went to an English school in a motor bus. The grandmother could not accompany him to the school as there were no dogs in the streets. The grandmother took to feed the sparrows. As the year rolled by, they saw less of each other. In spite of her immense interest in his studies, she could not help him in his lessons. As he was learning English, the law of gravity, Archimedes' principles, and many more such things which she could not understand. This made her unhappy. Sometime she would ask him what the teacher had taught him. Now we will going to see about the grandmother distress and disturb. Grandmother didn't believe in the things taught at the English school and was distressed to learn that there was no teaching about God and the scriptures in the school. Moreover, she was very disturbed at the idea of music lessons being given at the English school. To her, music had lewd association and she considered music to be unsuitable for gentle folk. So, as I have already told you, that she start feeding sparrows. So we will going to see the common link of friendship get snapped. The common link of friendship between the author and the grandmother was broken when the author went to university and was given a room of his own. The grandmother accepted her loneliness and rarely spoke to anyone. All the day, she sat spinning the wheel, reciting her prayer. Only in the afternoon, she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. They perched on her shoulder and some even on her head, but she never shooed them away. It used to be the happiest half hour of the day for her. The author leaves for the higher studies. The author decided to go abroad for higher studies for 5 years. He was sure that his grandmother would be upset at his departure, but she had not been even sentimental. She came to the railway station to see him off. She showed no emotion. She was absorbed in praying and counting the beat of her rosary. Silently, she kissed his forehead. The author thought that perhaps it was the last sign of physical contact between them. The grandmother celebrated the author's return and fall sick. As you know, when the author has already left the place for higher studies, when he returned, the grandmother was in full fame to celebrate his return. After 5 years, the author found his grandmother at the station when he returned. She held him in her arms. He found her more religious, more self-contained. He could hear her reciting prayers. Even that day, the happiest moment for her was feeding the sparrows herself. However, something strange happened to her in the evening. For the first time ever, she did not pray. Instead, she collected the women of the neighborhood, got an old drum, and started to sing song of homecoming of warriors. They tried to persuade her to stop, to avoid overstraining herself. But she didn't listen. She fell ill the next morning. She had danced a lot, she had sang a lot,
So she was not well. Now we will going to see grandmother's death. The grandmother was diagnosed with a mild fever by the doctor, but she insisted that her end was near. She told everyone that she did not want to talk to anyone and would rather spend her last moment praying. She ignored everyone's protest and started counting the beads in her rosary while praying. After a short while, the author noticed that his grandmother's lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. She died a peaceful death. She was covered with a red shawl. She always used to feed sparrows. So when she passed away, see the scenario of the sparrow, what the sparrow did. A sparrow also became silent when she passed away. When the author and the others came to take away the grandmother's body, they met a strange sight. To mourn her death, a lot of sparrows had surrounded the grandmother's body. They were all silent. When the author's mother offered the sparrow some bread, they refused to eat and quietly flew away after the grandmother's body was carried away for the last rites. So this is all about your lesson. Thank you.